Hi, Jim Shaw here from Crystal Group. I wanted to spend a moment just talking about MIL-STD-810, and today we're focused on acoustic noise, which is method 515. And what's this all about? Well, surprisingly enough, this is a lot like vibration, method 514, but acoustic noise is really how a product that you're building responds to a noisy environment. It could be someplace that's mounted next to a jet engine. It could be external stores on an aircraft. It could be next to a rocket motor on a missile. A lot of the things that you're testing here are pressure waves. And these waves can be from 5 kilopascals to 87 kilopascals. So it's actually quite a bit of energy in those areas that you're looking at where it's noisy. And those pressure waves induce essentially vibration. And that vibration can impact your equipment. So the frequencies of that vibration are anywhere from 10 hertz to really 10 kilohertz. There's a lot of energy in that area. So the things that you're looking for in acoustic noise really is, how does your equipment stand up to that kind of noise? So you're looking for the same kind of things that you're looking for in vibration. Is there fatigue? Is there chafing of wires? Are you breaking solder joints? Are you damaging any of the equipment materials or any of the structure? So ironically, it's a lot like the vibration spec. It's just being applied by, rather than kinetic motion from a variety of different input mechanisms, you're actually deriving that energy and putting it into the system through sound waves. So that's in effect what you're doing when you're doing acoustical testing. There are three kinds of acoustical tests. There's a diffuse acoustic noise, and that's essentially the equivalent of mounting your external stores on an aircraft. So what kind of vibration would that create? Then there's also grazing incident noise, and that's essentially equipment that's located in a ducted area that would have a very loud type of an environment, very noisy environment. And then the last one really is cavity resonance. And so you get into that sometimes when you're in a bomb door area or a storage area where a door's open, and then you get kind of a buffeting resonance type of an energy. And that can be quite destructive also. This test is a life test. So you're really testing the endurance of the product. As every other method in MIL-STD-810, each one of these methods has to be tailored, each procedure tailored to the specific application. So you're looking for, you know, how does the equipment stand up to that type of exposure, to those energy levels? And so that's in essence what you're trying to test for with this particular acoustic test. And so it's a lot like the vibration types of testing that we do, and that's what we're kind of looking for. I hope that's helpful. Thanks a lot.
Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group.